I once had a friend in college who borrowed my hard drive to transfer some files. And when he was done with it, I saw him yank the cable straight out of the laptop. No ejecting, nothing. Just pulled it. No hesitation whatsoever. Yeah, we're not friends anymore. I've been using hard drives for years now, and this 4TB hard drive was just my latest addition to a growing range of storage solutions. It's great for the most part, and I don't really have any issues when using hard drives. The only problem is it can get really slow, especially when you're transferring big files. The issue with transferring so much files so frequently is that there are times wherein you lose a file, or something gets corrupted, or it just doesn't back up for some reason. And I've run into that countless times. I remember 2 years ago, I transferred a file while I worked on something else. And when the time came for me to edit that particular vlog, it gave me the whole error missing files. And I guess the first time that I backed it up to the hard drive, something went wrong. I don't even know what went wrong. The connection was fine. I left it, it backed up. That's the problem. Sometimes something goes wrong, even if you try to do everything right. It's crazy. It's crazy, and it's a freaking nightmare to lose files. It's just the biggest hassle ever. And I even know someone who in the past year was just browsing through their photo album, and all of a sudden, her laptop just hacked. It just froze. And then it was the spinning wheel of death. It's probably my fault, because I said, why don't you just refresh it? And she did, and everything started working again, except when she went to look at the file, it was just gone. That was it. She was just viewing it, her laptop froze for no apparent reason, and then she lost the entire album. And I feel partly responsible for that. So if you're watching this, I am so, so sorry. So yeah, hard drives are necessary, but they're not always reliable. And I know probably a couple of you out there have similar horror stories to share. If you do, definitely share them in the comment section so I don't feel like I'm alone. But the great thing is, through the years, technology has advanced, and now we have SSDs, which are solid state drives. But those things are hella expensive. But after my last tragic horror story with losing files, that was it. I drew the line and I said, okay, I'm going to invest on an SSD. The problem is I only had enough money to buy a 500 gig SSD, but that was gonna have to work. And for the most part, it was great. Fast forward to now where everyone has been stuck at home and I find myself making more content, which means I need more space. Thankfully, for some reason, the stars aligned, or they probably heard me complain about it, but the sponsors of this video is Western Digital, and they sent over their 1TB My Passport SSD. Probably the thinnest SSD that I've ever held. I mean, just look at it. It's crazy thin. And I don't really know much about SSDs because I've only ever owned one, and that was a couple of years ago. So it didn't really stick to me when they told me that this was running on NVMe technology. I mean, I don't know what that means. But last night I was transferring files to make space on my laptop. I transferred a project folder that was about 30 gig, and I was really surprised because the transfer on this one finished way earlier than the one on the old SSD. And I guess that's thanks to the NVMe technology that they're using here. So we've already established that SSDs are great, and they're way better than HDDs or hard disk drives like these. But it's not for everyone, especially because it has such a high price point. So here's a really simple guide to know whether or not you should invest on an SSD or you should stick with an HDD. Now, the fastest way to determine this is to figure out what kind of files you're working with. Are you working with hot files or cold files? Cold files are essentially files that you don't access on a daily basis, such as family vacation photos or albums of family reunions. Then you're better off with a hard drive because it gives you more space for less amount of money. Now, if you're someone who works with hot files, wherein you're working with databases, files, so on and so forth that you're constantly accessing, and you need the power and the speed, as well as like the portability, then you definitely want to invest on an SSD. It's way more expensive, but you're not only paying for the storage, but you're also paying for the performance, the convenience, the power, all that stuff. So definitely set aside money to invest on an SSD. I, for one, do not regret my purchase. But buying hard drives and investing in SSDs are not the only things that you can do to improve your workflow. Some of the other things that I've done is to have a proper file system. And if you want to learn more about that, then watch this video to know how I organize my files. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye! I really have a hard time saying digital. That word. It's the bane of my existence.